It's a diverse and powerful collection about one theme, ceremony. Ceramics, painting and weaving at Australia's National Gallery. It's been built by curator Hetti Perkins, exploring the role of ceremony as the key link between country, culture and community.
Well, it's the idea of ceremony is something I think that's very prevalent in our communities, you know, in our daily lives, as well as no matter where we are, whether we're at bush or in town or in the cities. And that's something that comes through, of course, very strongly in the work of our artists. And so it was a really interesting process to sort of talk about the idea of ceremony with artists and not to be too prescriptive, just to say this, you know, what does it mean to you?
The exhibition brings together 38 First Nations artists and includes 19 newly commissioned works. Some have a deeply political message about protecting country.
Well, I think that being Aboriginal in this country today means you're political, you know, and that's something that comes through in the artists' works. And some of them are very activist works, you know, they're very forthright and clear. Others are more subtle in their messaging, but I think they are all works that very much have an active element.
The concept of ceremony is brought to life through visual art, film, music and dance, each artist creatively exploring their take on ceremony. Wiradjuri artist and choreographer Joel Bray's video installation is his first gallery exhibition.
So the work I've made is called Giraro Galangana Giri, and that means in Wiradjuri, the wind will bring the rain. The idea for this work came in the middle of lockdown when we were all stuck at home and everything was feeling very bleak and apocalyptic. It still kind of does, right? So the work is a choreographic meditation on the ancientness of country. And of course, being blackfellas, like Wiradjuri country has been cared for time immemorial by our people. And so you'll see in the work, it's kind of lots of images of scar trees and boundary trees, and the locations were chosen very carefully in consultation with elders from around the Wagga Wagga area, because they have particular meanings, or there were places of significance in our stories and in our lore.
The work Mullingar Yirrwong, Alive and Strong, by Dr. Matilda House and her son, Paul Girrawah House, comprises the scarring of a series of trees in the gallery's sculpture garden. They are a lasting reminder of the unbroken connection to country.
It's been wonderful. Murrumbung Malang Noyagoy Malang. It's been wonderful. It's been fabulous to be able to mark and carve trees in the style and the manner of the old people here at the NGA in the sculpture garden. The tree scarring, the markings, is all about acknowledging Biame, our creator, our protector Biame, and acknowledging the legacy and the pathways created by the old people for us to be able to stand, you know, on country and speak for country, and its custodians look after country.
Yolngu artist Gutanjara Yunupinu created his work, Maralicha, exploring the importance of ceremony and his connection to Northeast Arnhem Land, from which he has travelled. He's speaking here through an Auslan interpreter.
My community do travel a lot, and you're right, I have travelled a long way to come to Canberra. It took us a long time, it was a very long trip. So now that I'm here in Canberra, it's just wonderful. I'm very excited and very happy to see my work on such a large screen. It's really wonderful. When people walk on a beach, I want them to think about our culture, the importance of water, our totem, the crocodile. For us, it's the crocodile. And I want them to think about that.
The exhibition has been forged over several years through the crises of the pandemic and natural disasters, which a number of the artists themselves have been caught up in. Hetti Perkins says it's vital that Australians hear its central message about country.
I think it's really important that audiences come to this exhibition and really look, you know, and listen and feel what the artists are telling them, because, you know, I think we know that we're in a state of crisis. You know, culture is your country, culture and community are what ceremony is all about. And in recent years, you know, we've seen that significant devastation that's been happening on country, and a lot of our artists and community members are really worried about that, you know, worried, sick about it. And so I think it's a very important message that they're sharing with us.